Grimshaw. We're here at Signal Gallery in Hoxton. It's the last day of my solo show, Echoes and Exorcisms. So we hope we document the blubber show and I've got to talk about one. And this piece is called Chloe. It's a relatively new piece. I did it within a couple of weeks of the show opening in April. And it's a little bit of a beaten track for me in the sense that it's all works in monochrome as opposed to full colour. I just wanted to be mainly concerned with the rhythm of the painting, which I refer to the rhythm, the actual brush strokes, over the horizontal or vertical diagonal. I just really wanted to concentrate on the energy and the atmosphere of the painting. This one's quite unusual again in the fact that it's the first one in quite a while that I've used a female poet. And his friend originally put calls for the photographs. Again, I worked from a lot of photographs, so it makes sense. It fits in with some of the ideas that I've chatted about my work. There's two different elements to my work, kind of polarised opposites. We've got this very painterly, kind of fluid, organic side, which is influenced by, lots of the abstract expressionists, especially Franz Klein. And you can see here he's quite aggressive and energetic bush moths. And on the other side, there's the very, my interest in that, couple that I refer to as a painterly realist, like Freud, contemporaries like Jenny Saville. And the Glasgow people were a big influence when I was at college as well, people like Peter House and Kane Curry. Not so much now, but they were kind of very at the formation of my painting skills. So you've got a very academic side, and we've got this very kind of fluid, kind of abstract approach to my work. Also, again, with the influences, there was people like David Hockney's photo montages had a big impact on me. The way he used the kind of deconstructed photographs to pick out focal points and try and capture really the way we see, when we walk into a room and all the information our brain is kind of trying to unpick and actually trying to make some sense of. So there's an element of this collage kind of effect, which also fits in as well with my interest in kind of the punk scene. When I was younger, I was very much, visually as well as musically interested in people like Jamie Reid, who did the Sex Pistols work, and in particular G. Roach, who did the Crass, the political, politicised artwork for the covers of the Crass. Opposites, and I'll often work on the canvas with blocking in the skeleton of the painting, and I'll work separately on this canvas paper at the side. And when everything's dry, I will then dissect the actual detail. It's not photorealism, it's quite detailed and quite tight. I'll dissect this work on paper and then decide, just pick, play around with it. It's quite an improvisatory process, and play around with what will work and what won't work and what will fit in with the feel and the energy of the work. I mean, as you can see, the eyes are very obvious and quite present. I mean, eyes are very, very important in my work, and they're very important to as people, coming back to that Hockney about, picking up and eliminating information and homing in on information. Eyes are very important in terms of the way we interact, and for me personally, quite fascinated by people's eyes. So they often come up, and they're often the focal point of the work. But like I said, you don't always, with that improvisatory approach to colour, you don't always know what the end result is going to be when you turn the painting round to do another painting session after everything is then all the layers are dry. And this one was quite a surprise. It was, despite all the quite aggressive and brush strokes, it's actually got a very kind of gentle feel, and she's got a very inquisitive kind of look about her. And there's also a secondary face to the left here, which not a lot of people really pick up on when they look at the work, which is really good. It just didn't work really in the initial mapping out of the composition, and it's very, very subtle. Not a lot of people pick up on it, which I think is quite lovely as well. It doesn't really grab you instantly. You have to look at the work. So again, with this technique, it's kind of You never really know what you're going to get until you've applied all the pieces together, and then you've still got the option of reworking it as well. And I really decided to keep all the top quite dark and have the emphasis and the energy coming down diagonally from this bottom left corner, and just left it as a very kind of and just left it and tried to keep some of that energy without. And it's very easy to overwork things and lose that initial energy. And I think I captured that quite well with this piece. It's a beautiful piece.